Guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Ananya. If you're new here, please subscribe. So welcome to episode 3 and the last episode of the Bali series. I am currently in Nusa Penida, but I'm going to take a ferry from here to our next place, that is Sanur. And Sanur se hum jaane wale hain Seminyak wali side. So Seminyak wali side mein you can cover Seminyak, Canggu, Kuta. We're staying in Kuta, jo dono ke beech mein hai. Wahan se we'll also go to Uluwatu one day. That's the next plan. So let's get this trip started. All right, to the ferry. Hey guys, so we finally reached Kuta and we're staying at Ramayana Suites. It's a resort and a beautiful resort, I must say. We booked a really luxe property. It's a 5-star resort in Bali, so it's amazing. The pool is so cool. Abhi hume room 2 baje milega. We arrived quite early here, so they gave us access to the suite lounge. We had some snacks and now we're just exploring the beautiful property. So our resort has not one, not two, but 3 restaurants inside. Then there's a pool and a spa next to it. These are some of the rooms. So now we're just waiting for our room to get ready so that we can go quickly freshen up and head to Uluwatu. It's finally time to check into our room and of course I'll give you a room tour. So this is where you enter from. And first up we have a wardrobe. This is the washroom. Then we have an entire kitchenette, a microwave oven, some cutlery. There's a coffee machine and the pods and the different types of teas are here. So we've booked a family suite connected room. So we have this common lounge area. There's a TV unit. There's also a water dispenser over there. Some seating area and there's a balcony. View kuch khas nahi hai, just some greenery around and over there in the corner is the pool. This is the second room, quite similar to the first one, and the best part is the balcony. At night it feels like you're in a jungle. Love the vibe. Now it's time to head to Uluwatu. Although it's around an hour away, but due to traffic it took us about 2 hours, which is a lot. On the way we saw the Garuda Vishnu statue, Bali's most iconic landmark, and depicts the Hindu god Vishnu. It's actually inside the GWK cultural park, which you can visit if you have the time. So we finally reached the Uluwatu temple. This is the most famous spot here. You need to wear a sarong to cover up, and there are many popular beaches in Uluwatu that you should definitely visit. Unfortunately we didn't have much time, so we came here directly. Uluwatu Temple is known for its magnificent location, perched high on a cliff overlooking the Indian Ocean. Now let's be honest, there's not a whole lot to do here besides admiring the view, but oh, what a view it is. The ancient stone structures are pretty cool too, and you can't beat this clifftop location. Watch out for the monkeys though, they are cute but sneaky, so keep your belongings close. We're actually killing time while waiting for the Kechak fire dance tickets that our driver was going to get for us. Pro tip, the queue for these tickets is crazy long, so come early or be prepared to wait. After finally getting the tickets, our show was actually later in the day, so we headed to the famous Single Fin Beach Club. Again, it's on the cliff overlooking the Uluwatu Beach, which is known for its epic waves and surf culture. The view here is incredible. We grabbed some food and just chilled watching people surf. So much fun. And Single Fin has the perfect laid-back vibe. The food was pretty good too. As we were leaving, we couldn't resist a quick gelato stop. Nothing beats a cool, creamy treat before heading back for the show. Back to the Uluwatu Temple, ready for the Kechak fire and dance show. This show takes place in 2 slots from 6 to 7 and 7 to 8 p.m. only on certain days. The tickets also get sold out very quickly. Thousands of people show up for the show and that's how popular it is. The dance performance tells the main story from the Hindu epic Ramayana. Performance itself was entertaining with unique choreography, audience participation also, and even some comedy thrown in. It's a fun, family-friendly evening activity. On our way back, we took a stop at this 24-hour supermarket of sorts called the Krishna Market. Got a few bath and body products along with gifts for friends and family. And before going back to our room, we also went to the Kuta beach, which is really close to our hotel.
Hey guys, I'm back from our little day trip to Uluwatu and it was okay. The Uluwatu temple was, I don't know, कुछ ज़्यादा था नहीं देखने के लिए, इतनी देर हम वेट कर रहे थे. Finally, we got the tickets of the second show of the day, the Kichak fire dance, which was nice. अच्छा depiction था of the whole Ramayan, जो हमारे लिए relatable भी है. But I feel like इतनी भीड़ हो रही है, but probably the other foreigners won't even understand the story. Like we are Hindus, so we know what's happening. But otherwise, it's so difficult. वो dance show से तो कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा था. But anyway, I think we love the vibe of this place, Kuta. एक तो हमारा hotel एकदम center में है. So the market, the malls, even in fact water park is really close to our hotel. So वैसे vibe बहुत मस्त है इस जगह की. And even Changu में बहुत सारे beach clubs हैं, इतने सारे हैं कि हम सारे cover भी नहीं कर पाएंगे. Like Fins, Potato Head, La Brisa, ये famous वाले हैं. So yeah, like we're gonna see कल क्या करते हैं. But one thing we realized today is that if you have a good driver in Bali, तुम्हारी trip बहुत better हो सकती है. Like today we found this driver randomly, हमने एक grab book करी थी hotel आने के लिए, and then he also turned out to be like a कैब ड्राइवर फॉर द फुल डे एंड ही लिटरली न्यू एवरीथिंग ऑल द गुड प्लेसेस ऑफ ओबुद, कौन सी जगह हम एक्चुअली जा सकते थे. लाइक हम उसी एरिया में थे बट वी स्टिल डिडंट गो टू द प्लेसेस इन ओबुद. सो दिस गाय वाज लाइक रियली नाइस. आई लीव हिज कॉन्टैक्ट डिटेल्स इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑल्सो एंड ही ऑल्सो गेव अस अ रियली गुड लो रेट ऑल्सो. बट एनीवे, अब कल का प्लान है कि हम बहुत चिल करेंगे बिकॉज यू ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू यूटिलाइज द होटल दैट वी बुक्ड. बट हाँ, कल का प्लान तो कल ही बताऊंगी एंड दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे एंड आई विल सी यू गाइस टुमारो.
It's a new day in Kuta and we kick things off with a lavish buffet breakfast at our hotel. The spread was impressive. Then we headed straight to the famous Kuta beach. This is where it all happens. The golden sand stretches for miles and the waves are perfect for surfing or just splashing around.
Just like a 2-minute walk from our hotel. And wow, yahan pe itne sare log surfing seekh rahe hain. Even yesterday I showed you so many people surfing and it seems like such a cool thing to do, but I know it's super super tough. But kafi log lessons le rahe hain yahan pe. How nice. ओके, सो बाकी वाटर स्पोर्ट्स मैंने बहुत करे हैं, स्नॉकलिंग, जेट स्की एटसेट्रा, बट आई एम डूइंग अ वंस इन अ लाइफ टाइम एक्सपीरियंस दैट इज लर्निंग हाउ टू सर्फ. इट्स लुक्स वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट बट हम ट्राई करके देखते हैं. एक घंटे का लेसन है, लेट्स सी हाउ दैट गोज.
Kuta Beach is famous for its beginner-friendly waves, making it the perfect spot for surfing. We started on the sand, practicing the basics of surfing, and let me tell you, it's way tougher than it looks. Then it was time to hit the water. The waves weren't huge, but they felt like tsunamis to me, the newbie surfer. My first few attempts, let's just say, I got to know the taste of salt water pretty well. But with each wipeout, I got a little better. And then it happened. I actually stood up on the board. Okay, it was only for a few seconds but it felt like flying. By the end of the lesson I was exhausted but totally stoked. Surfing's not easy but it's definitely addictive. Whether you're a pro or a first timer like me, catching waves at Kuta Beach is an experience you won't forget.
Checking in with you after a very long morning, I should say. It's already 3:30. Surfing bhi kar li, swimming bhi kar li. Now I'm all freshened up. But let me talk about today's experience. Oh my god, if there's one thing I had to tell you to do here, is definitely go for surfing. It is very, very, very tough. And tum shayad nahi seekh paoge, shayad khade bhi nahi ho paoge to do the surfing actually. Maine bhi bahut mushkil se 3-4 baar kar liya tha. And I'm really proud of myself for doing that. The strength and also tumhara mindset is what really helps you to do surfing. But it's definitely a very fun and thrilling experience to say the least. And now we had plans of going to the Changu side. We wanted to go to Tanha Lot and even just chill at a beach club, but it is already raining. So we'll have to maybe cancel that plan and let's see what we do now. Abhi to hum pehle high tea pe jayenge of our hotel itself. Yeah.
We were just walking around Kuta and came across this mall, so we checked it out. Awesome place for shopping, got quite a few things from here. And then we came back to our hotel for dinner, and that's it for today.
Hey guys, so checking in with you after a while. It is currently 12:30 and ab hum finally bahar ja rahe to explore. We took the morning really slow, but ab hum soch rahe the pehle ki Canggu wagaira jaate hain, lekin I don't think it's worth traveling because bahut traffic hai yahan pe, aadha time to gaadi mein nikal jayega. So we're thinking we'll explore the nearby area. Yahan pe kafi acche malls wagaira bhi hai, and then after that we'll just go back to the beach for the beautiful sunset, maybe just chill at a beach club later. And yeah, this is my fit for the day, very beachy. But yeah, let's go.
Time for some more retail therapy at the Galleria Mall. It's actually super hot in Kuta, so we needed to do something indoors. This isn't your typical Bali experience, but sometimes you just need a shopping fix, right? It's one of the biggest malls in Kuta and it's got everything from local brands to international favorites. We did a bit of shopping, picked up some skincare and cute accessories. Prices are also pretty reasonable and you can find some good deals here. Came back to our hotel for the afternoon tea and then went to the Kuta Beach to just chill and enjoy the beach for one last time. We were just walking along the beach admiring this beautiful sunset, and chalte chalte we reached the Beach Walk Mall. This mall has a lot of high-end stores, very fancy place, so we strolled here for a bit. And came back to our hotel's cafe for dinner.
It's the next day and I'm checking in with you super early morning. It's currently 6:45 and it's time to leave Bali. Oh my god, these 9 days have passed so quickly and they were the most unique and adventurous days to say the least. So many different kind of experiences in Bali, but I would definitely do this one more time because abhi to aadhi jagah rahi gayi hai Bali ki, wo bhi important jagah. So much more to see and explore and so many better places, I'm sure. I think coming to Kuta in the end was the bright decision. Because यहाँ पे तुम्हें सिर्फ chill करना है, relax करना है. You can sit at the beach, go to the beach clubs, and that's all you do here. यहाँ पे ज़्यादा touristy चीज़ें हैं नहीं करने के लिए. अभी तो unfortunately we couldn't even go to all the beach clubs that were in Canggu or Seminyak. There is a lot of traffic over here, so एक घंटा तो minimum लगेगा कहीं भी जाने के लिए. इसलिए वापस आना पड़ेगा to go and stay in those places itself, ताकि तुम वहाँ की जगह cover कर पाओ. So yeah, now we're just gonna head down for breakfast and take our flight back to Delhi. So I'm gonna end this vlog right here. So if you made it till here, then comment these emojis and thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then don't forget to hit the like button, also subscribe to my channel, share this video with your friends, follow me on Instagram, and until next time, bye.